Welcome back. It is time for Juries Out. We're taking a closer look at some legal issues making headlines.
Legal expert Alison Triessl joining us today. Alison, always great to see you. Let's start with the Menendez brothers. LA District Attorney requesting a judge resentence them. They're currently serving life sentences for murdering their parents back in 1989. So this is happening now. We had the television show come out on Netflix. We had reports of Kim Kardashian visiting them in prison. What are the possible outcomes of the hearing?
I mean, and really, in so many ways, this is unprecedented. It is true that George Gascon has resentenced 300 people during his term as DA. 28 of them have been death cases. But let me start by saying it wasn't just a life sentence. It was a life sentence without the possibility of parole. So it was 25 years to life for each parent that they were convicted of. So that's 50 years to life without the possibility of parole. So what George Gascon is going to go into court and ask the court to do is to resentence them to 50 years to life, but with the possibility of parole. And what that would do, if the judge, they're not getting out right now. So there's a couple steps that still need to line up in order for them to be home. So George Gascon has made the decision that in the interests of justice, based on some of the new evidence that has been uncovered, the Marcy's Law sort of media display that his family, so Marcy's Law protects the victim's family. It's for the victim's family. That would be Jose and Kitty, but they all came out, 20 plus of them, in support of Lyle and Eric. And so he listened to them speak, saying, the time has come. These boys were in fact subjected to horrible abuse, both physical and sexual abuse. It's time for them to be released. George Gascon asked the court now for a resentencing, 50 to life with the possibility of parole. If the judge grants that, then they would go in front of a parole board. They've served 35 actual years in prison, apparently have been model inmates. They have done things like, formed support groups and been very active. They haven't had any disciplinary problems. So it is believed that the parole board would grant their parole, which would mean they would be released. Interesting fact I've shared on KTLA, but I'm going to share again. I went to high school with Eric Menendez and knew him fairly well.
Alison, before we move on to the next question, quick clarification. Might the judge simply take the LADA's recommendation and rubber stamp it, or does the judge have leeway to say, you know what, I understand what you're saying, I disagree, they're staying in jail?
Yeah, I mean, you know, everybody is, and that's, I'm so happy that we're covering this topic, because judges just don't rubber stamp whatever a district attorney says. And so it's going to be very interesting who this case is assigned to and how they see this case. The judge may very well go along with the resentencing and say, you know, I agree, they've served their time in custody, they've done a lot of really good things. I believe that it's fair at this point that they be resentenced. There is some additional evidence, although that's a habeas petition separate and apart, set to be heard at the end of November. So the judge could say, I'm not comfortable with this, I'm not going to resentence them. So it'll be interesting for us to find out who this judge is and whether or not he or she is willing to go along with the DA's sentence. That's a great question, Chris.
All right, moving along now, Alison. Shohei Ohtani's 50-50 home run ball, it's been sold at auction. This is bananas, for $4.39 million. But there's still a legal battle over who actually owns the ball. Just remarkable all the way around. Can you break the case down for us?
Yeah, and I have to tell you, this is like one of my favorite cases of all time. I mean, we're talking about people that bought tickets, right? For whatever they did. I mean, you know, I don't know how much these tickets cost, but they are potentially, one of them is walking away with $4.4 million. $1 million. It's incredible. Okay, so this is Shohei Ohtani's 50-50 ball. It was hit in during the Miami game. So this case is handled in Florida. And a guy by the name of Chris holds up the ball, claims that it's his. You see in the video, because there is a video, that there is a skirmish. There is, you know, everybody's hands, everybody except for the guy who's videoing it, hands, feet, you know, are all going after this ball. And there's this 18-year-old named Max who claims, and you see him right in the mix, you see him in the tussle in the mix, he says that his left hand had possession of that ball and that Chris, the older gentleman, wrapped his legs around Max's left hand and wrangled the ball out of him and ultimately stole the ball from him and took possession and then held it up for the world to see. So Max is suing him, asking that he be the rightful owner of the baseball. Here's some important things to understand. Before the ball is hit, it is owned by Major League Baseball. But once the ball is hit and it goes into the stands, it's considered abandoned property, and it is the person that possesses that ball that is the rightful owner. There is precedent here. Danny, if you know what that precedent is at all?
No.
Okay, Barry Bonds, 73rd home run ball. It's a big deal. It happens in 2001. And it was like the 700th home run, big deal. Ball was sold ultimately for $450,000. And there is a lawsuit between two gentlemen who, same kind of situation. They're both in the standing room only seats, skirmish over the ball, hands, feet, legs, arms, teeth, whatever. Everybody's in the mix. And what the judge in that case ultimately decided to do is because they had a tough time deciding who ultimately had possession, because at some point each of these men had possession. They had four law professors trying to explain what possession meant. And so they split up the proceeds. Here, the plaintiff, the 18-year-old Max, first asked the court for an injunction to prohibit the auction from going forward. No. Auction went forward. Bought money, the $4.4 million held in trust, Golden Auction House, all of the liability for them has been waived. For the new owner, the owner of the ball, they are also not involved in the litigation. The litigation now is just between Max, the 18-year-old, and Chris, the male, who are both claiming possession. Chris is the one that actually walked away with the baseball. And what is so amazing to me is the attorneys here did a couple smart things so far. They both agreed that do not do the injunction on the auction, because that ball, you don't know if that ball is, I mean, it's $4.4 million, right? I mean, that's a lot of money. You don't want it to be held off where it doesn't have the kind of interest, monetary interest, that it did at the time, $4.4 million. So that went through, held in trust. If I'm these lawyers, I'm actually gonna give them legal advice. If I'm these lawyers, I agree to settle this matter out of court and somehow split those proceeds, because walking in there as an all or nothing proposition, when I've seen the video, I don't know if any of you have, it is not easily distinguishable. It seems as though at one point, Chris, you know, he holds up the ball, he's in possession of the ball. The kid it was his 18th birthday, claims that there was a struggle. He had the ball in his left hands. But I don't think there's clear video evidence enough to establish either one of them actually took immediate possession of the ball. So if I'm them and I'm their lawyers, I say, look, let's settle this out of court. It's a lot of money. I'm going to loop around from where I started. Those people came in there without the expectation of being multimillionaires. If they're smart, they'll agree on a settlement.
I'll tell you, at the beginning of this, I thought, oh, Max. At the end of this, I'm thinking, yeah, Max.
Right.
Yeah.
Or at least
possible. I mean, that's my point. He's gonna get something.
Isn't possession 9/10 of the law?
So in this, it's a very interesting thing. In this, the other court, the Barry Bonds court found, in, you know, What is constructive possession? Who initially did you have possession of that ball? And but for the interference of the other fans, you would have retained possession of the ball, right? So it wasn't just that he had the ball and then, you know, he drops it himself. No, there are other intervening acts that may have taken the ball away from him. There may have been a cause of conversion where he lawfully had that ball and then other acts interfere and take the ball away from him. So if I'm them, and you know, it's like an O Max, well, you can substitute that O Max for an O Allison because you, and I don't sue anybody, but you can bet I would put my hat in the ring in
Oh, for sure.
I mean, this, and I the guy that sat there and that videoed the whole thing, yeah. I'm thinking, dude, put your phone down. If you were in the mix, you could buy like a lot of those phones.
Exactly.
You could have been in the mix to get the ball.
Exactly. Yeah. They're all putting their hat in the ring.
I'm with Megan, though. She said the kid should have done more push-ups. I'm kind of with her on that. She didn't say that. You're a lawyer.
I don't want to misrepresent it.
You know, the comments that, you know, I researched the case, and they're like, dude, you got to hit the gym. I mean, come on.
Oh, poor Max.
I'm teasing.
Maybe not poor Max. Maybe very rich Max.
Yeah, there you go.
If Max's lawyers listen to me, Max may have $2.2 million if they split up and settle out of court.
Well, the lawyers each will get $1.5 million, yeah, and Max and Chris will get $400,000.
Henry, do you think I appreciate that?
No, I don't think
she studied hard for her license.
I'm a lawyer.
I'm going by the class action. Exactly. Suits. I'll leave that out.
Yeah. Allison, you're the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Allison.
Have a great day, guys.
Sorry, Allison.
For more information about Allison or her practice, you can visit AllisonTriessl.com. We'll be right back.